Welcome back to my channel. If you are new, my name is Amy, and today I'm going to share with you how I organize my small kitchen. So first of all, I want to tell you this is not a how you should organize your kitchen. That is not what this is. This is just a how I organize my small kitchen. Everybody is unique, everybody's family is unique, and you have to organize in a way that works for you. And what may work for one person doesn't necessarily work for another person. When you are watching, do watch for what I do have, because I feel like people have way more than they need to have. But we are not entertainers. Like, when we do have people over and we do entertain, maybe for birthday parties and things like that, we use disposables. So that might be different for you if you entertain all the time and you want a set, more sets of dishes just for more people. But we have one set of dishes, so 12 plates, 12 little plates, 12 big bowls, 12 small bowls, like that. That is all we need. When you see our cups, you're gonna see we do not have very many. We have 3 big cups, 3 medium-sized cups, and 3 small cups. That is all we need for our family. We don't need any more than that. And then we do have some kids' cups, and you'll see that. All day long, I drink out of this. I love this so much. This is like my favorite thing ever. This is in my Amazon store if you wanna look at it. But we all have something like this that we drink out of all day long. We just refill it with water all day, so we're not going through a bunch of cups. Also, because our house is so small, we don't have room for all of our canned goods and, you know, like my blender and waffle maker and muffin tins, all of that kind of stuff. That is all down in our basement just because we do not have space in our kitchen for it. Like I said before, this is just how we do it. I hope you get some ideas. However, I do believe that you should not have clutter on your counter. Your counters should be clutter-free, and there's no reason to have stuff on the counter. If your house is cluttered, your mind is cluttered. Even if it doesn't bother you and you don't even think anything of it, it is subconsciously cluttering your mind. That is a different video though. Subscribe if you want to see more. Please give this video a thumbs up so I know if you guys are enjoying it, if I should continue with stuff like this. All right, on to the kitchen. Here is an overview of our kitchen. I thought it would help you to see kind of what it looks like before I start diving into all the cabinets and stuff. So that is what it looks like. This is what we're working with here. This cabinet here is where we keep all of our dishes. So we have all of the big plates, we have small plates, we have kid plates, and then we have some kid bowls. And then way back here, I have some glass bowls that I use for like Jell-O and things. Andy likes that for dipping. And then I have our little corn pricks, some toothpicks, and these are all the tops to these. And I actually use these more than anything in here for the kids. They love these. I love those. Up here we don't have a lot of space, so we have 3 big glasses, 3 medium glasses, and 3 small glasses. And then this little one right there is just to measure out juice when Henry's low. We measure out so many carbs of juice. We have straws, some 2 different size bowls, and then butter. Our butter dish stays up here. Up here on the top we have a couple mugs, like for when we have hot chocolate. We are not coffee or tea drinkers. We just use them for hot chocolate. Andy has, those are his big cups there that he likes to use. And then we have 2 big bowls. So these are all of our dishes. Under our island here, it's not very much space. It's really narrow because it's not technically, it used to be like a cabinet on the wall. But in here, there's enough room for a few things. So we have kids' cups in here. So that's where everything is for them. The rest of this cabinet is Tupperware. This is all the Tupperware. We have this Tupperware, some down here, plus the kids' snack bowls. More Tupperware, and then just like all the, you know, cling wrap and the Ziploc bags and stuff like that. This is our silverware drawer. It looks kind of like a mess, but it's an organized mess. All the kids' stuff is right here, and then all of our bag and chip clips are right here. Timer, thermometer. I use this just for chicken because I don't like using my good knife for chicken for some reason. I don't know, just like nutcracker, kebab stuff. So just stuff that we don't use quite as often, but we need a spot for it. So that is what's in that drawer. This drawer looks like a giant mess, but again, it's an organized mess. It's just all of our spatulas, anything for baking and cooking, or wooden spoons, our scrapers, and meat pounder, whisk, stuff like that. So that is all in this drawer. We have so little counter space that a lot of people have cute Crocs with them all out, sitting out, but we do not have space on our counter for that. We don't have an overhead microwave or whatever you call it, so that takes up a lot of our counter space. This bottom drawer, we have all of our kitchen towels. These are our what we wipe the, like, Charlie's mouth and hands off with.
our dish rigs, and then I have our hot pads and our trivets. So that is where that is. Under the stovetop here is where we keep all of our pots and pans and pie dishes and mixing bowls and casserole dishes and stuff. So that is what's under here. Under the oven here, we have cookie sheets, our pizza pans, cooling racks, strainer, and some cutting boards. Way up here on top, I can't reach it without standing on a chair, but it's our popcorn maker. It's like a Whirl-O-Whip popcorn maker, so that is where that is. What is up here? Oh, up here is all of our measuring stuff, measuring spoons, measuring everything. Up here we just keep some food because we have so little pantry space, it's insane. So we keep food up here. What is in here? Here we have our salt and pepper, our peanut butter, and then just like our oils and stuff. All right, lastly is our pantry, just like all of our snacks and stuff like that, stuff we grab for lunches. Way back in here is where we have all our spices and all our seasonings. Oh, I almost forgot that underneath here, this is such a pain. It's hard having a small space. But under here, I have my crock pot and my rolling pin, our toothbrush, our toaster, and then our like molds and stuff. On this side, there's our hand mixer, banana bread pan, more of like cake pans and stuff. So, and cake decorating stuff down there. So that is everything. I lied. I forgot. Totally forgot I have this. This is a 100-year-old cabinet, which I love, and I would love just to have pretty dishes in it, but since our house is so small and we don't have a lot of space, this is where I have all of our lunch, our school lunch stuff, and I usually have a pitcher, but we're using it right now, like water pitcher right there, and just lunch, got our lunch stuff. I do have some wine glasses and I use these for smoothie glasses here as well. If I move someday, see all these unique different teacups. They're all so unique. I love them. I love collecting them. I would love this whole thing to be really pretty dishes. Thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you got some good ideas. Please let me know in the comments below. Did you learn anything? Is there anything different that I do that you don't do? Is there something I have a ton of that you don't have anything of, or vice versa? Please let me know in the comments below. Check out my organization playlist, which is up here. You can check out toy organization and shoe organization and things like that. So click on that if you want to see more, and I will see you soon. Bye, everybody.